Hi, and welcome to my first video in the series about membranes, and today we're going to be looking at the structure of the plasma membrane. So the first thing to really realise about cells is there are a number of different membranes found within the cell, and so some of them are just listed down here. So you have a plasma membrane, which is this one labelled here on the outside, the tonoplast. You also have one on the mitochondria. You have two on the mitochondria, for instance. There's one on an inside structure called a cristae, and you have one on a chloroplast. Also there's some form of a membrane on the nuclei as well. So membranes are found throughout, and today we're going to be mainly looking at plasma membranes. So the major function of a membrane is it allows a cell to be divided into different parts, and so you can have varied conditions in those different parts. A good example of that is a lysosome. So a lysosome is an organelle that contains digestive enzymes, and hence you wouldn't want those digestive enzymes freely swimming around the rest of the cell, as the rest of the cell would get digested. And so membranes, they act as a barrier and therefore stop the digestive enzymes getting out and therefore digesting the cell. And so the major constituents of membranes are these things called phospholipids, and from the name phospho, you probably guess that that's a phosphate, and lipids, hence a fat. And sometimes you see the diagram drawn like this, and this is what's referred to as a phospholipid bilayer, as there are two sections of it, hence bilayer. And if we magnify one of these sections here, you can see these different parts. So the first part at the top here is a phosphate group, as you'd expect with a phospholipid. You have a phosphate, which is made of phosphorus and oxygen. This second blue section here is called glycerol. It's another chemical. And the phosphate and the glycerol are held together by this phosphoester bond. And then at the bottom, these two green sections here, you have two fatty acids. The fatty acids are held to the glycerol via an ester bond. And this is basically what a phospholipid looks like. And there are two distinct regions to a phospholipid. The first, the top part, where the phosphate group is a hydrophilic head. Now, hydrophilic means, philic means to like, and hence the phosphate group on the top there likes water, hence hydro. The bottom end, where the fat is hydrophobic. So phobic means does not like, so does not like water. And you already probably know this, when you mix things like fats, oils with water, the two don't mix or emulsify. And so the top part likes water, the bottom section does not. So when phospholipids are placed into an aqueous solution like they are here, what you've got is you've got a polar hydrophilic head. Now polar just means that there's a charge involved on that section, and hydrophilic means to like water. And then you've got the tails, which are hydrophobic. And what ends up happening is the hydrophilic section, the bits that like the water, gather around the outside, and then the hydrophobic tails that do not like the water gather on the inside, and they form this structure called a micelle. And so the plasma membrane, it ends up looking like this structure, a phospholipid bilayer, because what you end up having, again, is the phosphate groups, which like the water, on the outside, and then the tails, which don't like the water, on the inside, so they're not exposed to them. And so in the conditions of the cell, on the outside of the cell, it'll be aqueous, and on the inside of the cell, it'll be aqueous as well. So this setup is preferential, and that's what's referred to as a phospholipid bilayer. And so in summary, a unit membrane consists of a phospholipid bilayer, and phospholipids are made up of a polar hydrophilic phosphate head, that means they like the water, and the non-polar hydrophobic tail consisting of fatty acid chains. So hydrophobic means they don't like the water, and hence they're found away from any aqueous solutions.